In this video, I will introduce you briefly to how grids are represented in MRST. A grid is a tessellation of a planar or volumetric object that consists of a set of contiguous, simple shapes which we call cells. Grids are distinguished by their geometry and topology. The geometry gives the shapes of the cells that form the grid, while the grid topology tells how individual cells are connected. In 3D, a cell is a closed polyhedron defined by a set of vertices, a set of edges that connect vertices, and a set of faces that define the interface between two different cells. In MRST, we assume that all grids are matching. To enforce this, we subdivide any non-matching faces into subfaces. When implementing grids in modeling software, you always have the choice between generality and efficiency. To represent an arbitrary grid, it is necessary to explicitly store the geometry of each cell in terms of vertices, edges, and faces, as well as storing the connectivity among cells, faces, and edges, and vertices. A lot of this information is obviously redundant for simple grids. For uniform Cartesian grid in 2D, for instance, the topology of the grid can be represented by two integer indices, and the geometry of the grid by two real numbers that give the side length of the rectangular cells. Using such a compact format will ensure that your code uses minimal memory and accesses the grid very efficiently. On the other hand, if you choose to represent the grid explicitly in this way, you will have to modify large portions of your code if you want to change to another type of grid. In MRST, we have chosen to trade efficiency for generality, so that you can implement solvers and computational algorithms without explicitly knowing what the grid looks like. We therefore represent all grids in an unstructured format, implemented as a struct in MATLAB. The structure is called G, or capital G by convention, and contains three substructs that represent the cells, the faces, and the nodes. The cell structure lists the faces that bound each cell. The face structure lists the nodes that define each face and the indices of the cells that share each face. For simplicity, cells are only assumed to be connected through faces. The third structure, the node structure, lists the coordinates of the vertices in the grid. Based on these three structures, we can compute geometrical properties like centroids, areas, face normals, etc. Altogether, this gives us a very flexible format that can be used to build and represent a wide variety of grid types. You can read more about this structure in the MRST textbook. In subsequent videos, I'll show you how you can use the various grid factory routines in MRST to generate various types of grids. I'll also show you how you can use scripts to tailor these basic grids to your own purposes. Finally, I will go through how you can input and process corner point grids given in industry standard input files.